toxins. I'm here today for many reasons. One being my passion for my dad's organic beef, but most of all, I'm here for my sons. You see, they are the future of America. The land is the future of America. And I would like to see my boys flourish and live in the land for years to come. Like many of us here today, I'm here to defend what TransCanada is willing to jeopardize. TransCanada's solution for temporary jobs should not outweigh our entire state's ag industry and the livelihood of many Nebraskans. The pipeline safety is based on shoulds, not certainty. We have already witnessed what their should philosophy is. Spills in the existing pipelines speak for themselves. This project is advertised as more jobs for Americans and a more convenient source of oil. Why then is the pipeline headed for the Gulf Coast? And how much of that oil is Americans going to get? What jobs, what about our jobs as farmers and ranchers? They can't sell toxic crops or toxic livestock. Given Keystone's track record, it's very likely that we will have a spill or a constant leak. So how do you clean up an oil leak in the sand hills? How do you separate sand oil and water? The answer is one answer. How do you clean contaminated water? It's not possible. Why should we risk contaminating our land and our water for our future farmers and ranchers? All for the sake of a temporary job solution and revenues. If God wanted underground oil in Nebraska, he would have put it here. But instead, he gave this not over, the Oglala over. Let's respect what so graciously has been given to us. Let's take pride in our land and our water so future generations can continue to prosper in the land like it was intended for. I ask you as a mother, a Nebraskan, and an American, please deny this pipeline route. Make your decision based upon long-term concerns, not temporary solutions. I thank you and my sons for